Labour's victory hinged on the telegenic charm of its eloquent frontman.
I want us to go from here tonight, working for New Zealand, rejoicing that we have had this victory and then setting ourselves to work together.
The honourable and the consistent thing, and pull out of the ANZUS alliance, for whether you are snuggling up to the bomb or living in the peaceful shadow of the bomb, New Zealand benefits, sir, and that's the question with which we charge you, and that's the question with which we would like an answer, sir.
And I'm going to give it to you if you hold your breath just for a moment. I can smell the uranium on it as you lean towards it.
The 25 years ago was at the centre of an international scandal blown up in Auckland Harbour by spies with orders from Paris to stop a planned protest against French nuclear testing. Martini Gocci was one of 10 Greenpeace activists caught in the explosion.
I'm an angry man, you know.
Angry that justice has never been served to his mate, Fernando Pereira, who was killed in the blast. Two of the bombers captured by New Zealand were jailed for 10 years but served only two after France threatened trade embargoes. The Rainbow Warrior sank just 4 minutes after the second bomb was detonated.
Will be some pain. Some of that pain may well elicit the odd scream. So much larger
than life. Oh, not Mr. Bolin. Him gone. No good. Blah, blah. The place where I come from is a small town.
They think so small, they use small words. There will be no fiscal blowout in this country while I am Minister of Finance.
The Longy government stands or falls alongside Roger Douglas. I'm heard enough. I'm getting out.
A conflict has developed between David and myself, which I cannot understand or explain.
Where'd I get my bag? Lands for bags, of course. Where else?
Where'd I get my bag? I pinched it.
We've got a date, the 14th of July, which we've worked out at Government House as being the appropriate date.
That doesn't give you much time to run up to an election, Prime Minister.
Doesn't give my opponents much time to run up to an election, does it?
And now he's back in close.
That is very comprehensive, and the new bat did little good. OBW, and will that be a wicket for Richard Hadley with his last ball in Test cricket?
He took a cold shower after some racist bum chummery or other. Our All Whites buggered Australia.
Mackay nicely into Wooden. There's the lethal left foot, and it's there! A great shot from Wooden.
Then belted Fiji with the world record 13-0 drubbing.
A goal! And another!
Fiji were shit airs.
Sport has never played something before.
We sent the Indonesians sulking off. We were fucking good.
Shit, look at that!
We were guided by British professionals who looked like a sort of middle-aged Bodie and Doyle planning how to collar the crib. And then all hell broke loose when a feckless referee took a whistle spanner to our works against Kuwait, then a protectorate of the Ottoman Empire. A suddenly knowledgeable crowd knew that we were being ripped off in our own backyard. And one cranky Kiwi took it upon himself to straighten out this bent ref by hoiking his stadium refreshment at the bugger. The crowd, clearly seen here, expressing their disapproval. Referee what's-his-name in a mysterious suitcase had to be spirited from the country under armed guard. Despite being reminded it was brown o'clock by advertising, our All Whites became household names. Brian Socksdown Turner evoked a Chatfieldian honesty. There was White Fro Herbert and even Bert from Sesame Street Sumner. They dared to dream the impossible and went about proving it with honest endeavour and a little help from the linesman. A laughable unlikelihood required a green-clad New Zealand to beat Saudi Arabia by 5 goals in Saudi Arabia. And we prepared for tears before bedtime. But a miracle on AstroTurf was about to unfold. A little known fact is that a young Osama bin Laden was at centre back against New Zealand that day. And some disturbing coincidences have only now been revealed. Watch as Winton Roofer drills it home against the Saudis. Watch the game clock. At the moment the Saudis are humiliated by Roofer's screamer, the time is 9 minutes 11 seconds. Coincidence? And watch again as a Saudi graphic appears to indicate the passage of impact into the Pentagon that would years later be manufactured by the hapless fullback that day, bin Laden. Oh. That mystery endures. But the final hurdle to soccer prestige was bravely grasped against China. And lo, New Zealand was to appear on the greatest sporting stage in the world, in the beautiful game. We even scored a couple of goals.
Challenging and scored.
Bert got one, Ernie the other. For one crazy year, we joined the world and did rather well, beyond the wildest dreams of soccer puffs nationwide, before normal transmission was resumed.